There's no pay for the Maxi Taxi Concessionaires as yet, and this led to a protest on Wednesday morning outside the PTSC office in San Fernando. Head of the School Transport Service, Rodney Ramlogan, said he was frustrated and has a suggestion to deal with the problem.
I am asking the Prime Minister and the Minister of Finance as well, stop paying all these managers and the staff in PTSC and the staff in the Ministry of Education who directly work with this Maxi system. Pay them together with us so let them feel how hard it is as well, because something is wrong with the processing of the forms and they're not doing it in a timely manner. Then the government had agreed, the Minister of Education had asked the both parties to have a tripartite meeting with ourselves and the PTSC and the ministry, and up to today, that meeting has not come to pass.
Mr. Ramlogan said the banks are on the heels of some drivers who for 2 years have been paying their loans only intermittently. He said he's in agreement with the required checks made by the Ministry of Education on the drivers' invoices. According to him, this process began because of irregularities being forwarded by the PTSC. Mr. Ramlogan, however, is insisting that the government tell the truth about whether they can afford to fund the service.
The PTSC used to use us to rob the government all the time, and apparently they picked up on it, but the thing is they need to have some process to get it right, and they're not sitting down and finding a formula to get it right, so that's why it always keep having a delay. And as well as we don't know if the delay is because they're doing it deliberately or because the government has no money and they just keep us hanging on a string. That's why I'm asking the Minister of Finance and the Prime Minister to say something about the school system if it is here to stay and they want to continue it.
The Maxi Taxi organization is warning that the small protest they had on Wednesday morning was the start of a more prolonged campaign. But they want to assure parents and students that they would not let those sitting this year's SCA suffer.